That's it? Before I close this chapter and I continue my investigation, are you sure that's the story you want to stick with?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's what it was. Okay. So now, unfortunately, you are under arrest, okay? For the burglary.
Thorough investigations can make or break a case, as Deputy Texas will find out. Hey, firm, I got a 1038.
Go over there, okay? Just so it's easier and we're not in an intersection.
Yep.
Alright, it looks like you got this under control. I'll be in the area, just let me know if you need help.
10-4. Hello, sir.
Hello, officer.
Deputy Texas with the Erie County Sheriff's Department. I'm sure you know why I stopped you, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Were you in a hurry somewhere?
New car. I was watching the speedometer, but I just realized that the bigger numbers are miles per hour, not kilometers.
Mm-hmm.
So I was going really fast.
Yeah, you're actually borderline reckless driving, which is an arrestable offense. You aware of that?
Yeah.
Yeah, do me a favor, grab your registration and license and meet me over here in front of your vehicle.
Yep. I do have a firearm. Just letting you aware of that.
Thank you for letting me know. All right, go ahead and have a seat right there in front of your vehicle for me. All right, partner, let me see that ID, please. Jonathan, Giles, have we had an interaction in the past? That name looks familiar.
Maybe.
Deputy Texas? I think I pulled you over for speeding.
It must have been a little bit ago.
Okay. All right. Give me just a second. All right. Just stand by right here, okay? All right, Mr. How do you pronounce your last name? Is it Giles?
Correct.
Okay. All right, Mr. Giles, have you been pulled over today at all?
Not today.
Okay. What about in the past few days?
In the past few days, I not pulled over. I believe Deputy Roth arrested me for drunk driving.
Oh, okay. Okay. So you're developing quite the rap sheet, my friend. What are we going to do to change behavior? Is it going to be me putting you in jail going to change your behavior, or maybe having a little talk with you and then that's going to modify your behavior? What are you thinking?
I'm going to get a slower car.
You're going to get a slower car. Okay. All right. So this is what I'm going to do, Mr. Giles. I'm not going to give you a ticket, okay? Because I'm sure you spending more money is not going to change anything. I am going to ask you man-to-man to please keep your speed down. Now, you're probably asking yourself, why do I have to keep my speed down? So I'm going to answer that question for you. One reason to keep the speed down is so that way we don't have collisions and we don't have to work fatalities on either yourself or somebody else, right? Obviously, you already got pulled over and arrested for DWI. Yeah. That's dangerous. I don't have to tell you that. It's all over the TV, all over everywhere, all over media, right? What it can do to people. It can kill people, including yourself. Do you have family, sir?
Yeah, I have a son.
Okay, you got a son. So you don't want to leave your son orphan, do you?
No.
Okay. So I'm kind of speaking to your morality here instead of me kind of writing you a ticket or even putting you in jail. Because I don't think, again, I don't think that's going to modify your behavior. Okay? So
okay.
I'm hoping that you're hearing me and that you'll take my warning. You'll heed to it. and that I will not be pulling you over for speeding anymore or any of the other deputies, because I am going to add you to the database. And basically what it's going to say, it's going to have your name and that I pulled you over for reckless driving, which is, an arrestable offense. So technically right now I should be putting you in cuffs and taking you to jail, okay? But I'm not going to do that. And I am going to note it there that I'm giving you a reprieve, okay?
Okay.
And the reason why I'm doing that is so the next deputy that pulls you over, when they see that little notation and they see my notes, then I'm sure they're going to have zero mercy on you at that point. Make sense? Including myself. Yeah. Okay. So let me ask you this while we're kind of chatting about it. Do you have anything illegal in your person or in the vehicle that I need to know about?
No, I do not.
Okay. You're being truthful, right?
Yes.
Okay. Do you have any arrest with drugs outside of the alcohol?
No.
No? Okay. What do you do for a living there, Mr. Giles?
I've been working with Quinn out on the docks.
Oh, cool. What do you guys do at the docks? Fishing?
He has me run and get stuff for him.
Oh, gotcha. Herons and stuff. Yeah, I've never worked with him before. I never heard. I don't even know how that works, so that's kind of cool. I used to flip burgers for a living before I did this. Anyways, I'm not going to delay you anymore. I'm going to let you get back to it. But again, Mr. Giles, we have an agreement between you and I, right?
Yep.
You're going to honor that, right?
Correct.
All right, sir. You're free to go. Have a nice day.
Okay.
Take care. I'm clear on that 1038, code 4.
10-4, boss.
Uh-oh.
And at Red 4 Raptor, south past the airfield, any available respond, code 2?
1-1, I'm in the area, show me responding.
Copy, 1-1.
Alright, we're looking for a Red Raptor, see if we find some. I think I ran.
That's a Raptor.
Yep, that's him. 1-1, I got a visual on that Red Raptor. One, do we know what, can you read back those notes from the RP? Can you read back the notes from the RP, that dispatch call for the Red Raptor? I'm not sure what I'm pulling them over for.
Call just says it was just two suspicious males peeling away from north of Sand Mine, possible home. And RP says they may have robbed a home in the area.
Oof. 10-4. That's kind of shady.
Yeah. I don't know. It's really hard to.
Technically, I mean, I can pull them over and talk to them, but hopefully they don't play tough ball with me. Let's talk to them. What the heck?
Might not be playing goofball.
Yeah.
Play some paintball with you instead.
1-1. I'm gonna be conducting a 1038 just to speak to the individual, the driver.
Affirm 1-1.
Show me out over at paintball. Hello, gentlemen. Can I have you step back in the vehicle real quick? Hello, gentlemen. I'm Deputy Texas of the Erie County Sheriff's Department. How are you?
Yeah, not bad.
Good, good. You're probably wondering why I'm talking to you, right?
Very much so.
Yeah. Well, no traffic violations whatsoever. We did get a dispatch report that there was a Red Raptor speeding away from one of the homes up over just north, I think actually in the Stony Ridge area, north on South Sand Mine. Were you guys coming from over there by any chance?
No.
Well, yeah, no. Yeah, no, maybe so.
We were checking the house, Amy, as you know, we're actually roommates, and we're actually just trying to find a new house.
Oh, you're fine. Oh, okay. So you're house shopping.
Yeah.
Gotcha, gotcha. Yeah. All right, cool. Nothing wrong with that. Do me a favor, driver, can I have you step out real quick? Let's chat. Bring your registration and license with you. And just to be clear, you're not under arrest or anything. You're not even being detained right now. I'm just chatting with you, all right?
Okay.
If I can see your license, that'd be great.
Yes, probably show that to you.
Yeah. All right, Mr. Justin, right?
Yep.
Hello, Mr. Justin. I'm Deputy Texas.
Hello.
So, Justin, do me a favor. Let's come over here and chat real quick.
All right.
All right, and I'm going to ask you to go ahead and kind of whisper. I don't, you know, so we don't make anybody else panic. So where you say you're coming from Sandmine. What were you guys doing in Sandmine?
We weren't inside there. We were just looking at some housing over there and went past it, so.
Okay, okay. And did you guys find a house you liked?
We were just mainly checking prices and that.
Oh, okay, okay.
See what the market's like.
So you guys are in the market for a home, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, okay. Now, what's that gentleman's name, the one with you?
Adam.
Kevin, you said?
Adam, ADA.
Oh, I'm sorry, Adam. Yep, yep. Your vocal cords are cutting off a little bit for some reason.
Yeah, sorry about that.
That's okay. All right, so Adam, huh? And he's been with you the whole time?
Yep.
Okay, okay. All right, do me a favor. Can you just have a seat right here in front of me? Just grab a seat. Yeah, I'm going to talk to your partner, and I'll be right back, okay? Thank you.
Frank, do you have Steve Marshall?
Hey, Hoffman, just kind of keep an eye on that guy for me, okay?
Yes, I do. Are you still here?
I'm out front.
All right, sir, can I have you step out for me and then meet me on this side of the truck? Thank you. Oh, there you go. You hopped right in front of me. Let's go over here to this corner right here, and if you don't mind, if I can have you grab a seat right there. Thank you, sir. All right, and can I see your license or ID, please?
Yeah, here you go.
All right, Adam, perfect. So, Mr. Adam, how do you know Mr. Justin?
Actually, if I remember right, I met him when he first got to the island. I showed him around a little bit and kind of just became friends since then.
Oh, okay, okay. All right, cool. So your new buddies just met? Or was this a while back? Okay.
It was a while. I just got back from vacation. Apparently, while I was gone, he was actually gone too.
Gotcha, gotcha. Well, just so you know, and the reason why I'm talking to you, gentlemen, obviously somebody called in to call 911.
And dispatch is going to go ahead and go 10-7 for about an hour.
Hold on just a second.
I'll be back.
10-4. So, so they got a call of some suspicious activity happening over at Stony Ridge, where people are breaking into homes. Do you know anything about that?
No, I wouldn't know anything about that.
No, nothing? Mm-mm. Okay. And you guys, what were you guys doing in that area? Were you guys doing sand mine, or what were you doing?
No, we were looking for a house.
Oh, you're looking for a house? What area were you guys looking in?
We were over in Stony Ridge, or we were on the main highway. I'm not sure if we were exactly in Stony Ridge, but we were on the road that you first turned around and started following us on.
Oh, okay, okay. And how many houses did you guys look at?
We were running up and down the whole street looking at all of them.
Okay. Now, there's no way that you guys didn't break into any of them, right?
No, we didn't break into any of them.
Okay. Do you consent to a search? I'm looking for any type of equipment that would lead me to believe that you guys were doing that or not.
I consent to you searching me personally. The truck's not mine, it's his. So yeah, me personally, yeah, go ahead.
Sure, absolutely. I appreciate that.
I do have a weapon in my bag. Okay. I do have a license. It's in my wallet.
You do have a license. Okay. All right, let me just run your name real quick through our database. And yes, I do show you owning a license. All right. Now, I before I pat you down, I have to put your hands behind, okay? But don't take that personal. Okay. All right. Let's see here. Let's see what we got. Okay. Ooh. Adam, I got bad news, my friend.
What's that?
Desert Eagle. Did you know that was illegal?
No, I bought this from somebody. It was, obviously, as you see, the American flag painted over. I'm a gun collector, so as you can see, there's a million guns on my feet right now.
Yeah.
And, I seen he showed me the American flag on it. I kind of just wanted it for my collection. I had no idea it was illegal.
Yeah, it's illegal. Yep. All the other ones, you're fine. The 50 caliber is where you went south on me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, all right. I'm going to go ahead and... all right. Let's see here. So, it looks like you're a mask collector.
Yep.
Okay. All right. Perfect. Well, I appreciate your cooperation, buddy. Just stand by for me, okay? I'm going to go ahead and let you pick up the rest of your weapons, the ones that are legal, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead and pick up your stuff. Give me a second here. All right, so go ahead and pick up all your stuff and do me a favor and just have a seat back down, okay?
All right.
All right, just keep an eye on for him. Okay, Mr. Justin. So, do me a favor. I'm going to go ahead and pat you down. And the only reason that I'm going to pat you down is, unfortunately, I already got an illegal weapon off of your buddy Adam. So I got to make sure you don't have anything on you. Okay? So I'm just going to have you stand up real quick. There you go. Thank you. Do me a favor. Look away from me. Thank you very much. And actually, I'm going to move you back a little bit. Just so that way your stuff doesn't get all lost. All right. So let's do a little. Let me take a quick look here. All right. Another Desert Eagle. Oh my gosh, man. And then you got an SDAR. Ugh. You understand those are illegal, right?
I found those. I just picked them up, so I didn't know.
Yeah. So, hold on. Oh, boy. All right, so I am going to be confiscating these, okay?
Yeah, okay.
I'm sure you don't mind.
Yeah, no, it's reasonable.
Okay. So do me a favor. Go ahead and let's see what else you got in here. Okay, I don't see nothing else. So outside of the Desert Eagle and the SDAR, go ahead and pick up everything else. I'm going to let you loose here. Appreciate you being cooperative.
No problem.
I
have a feeling I know who did that call. There's a white Taurus that was there. He was doing like 20 on the highway, just staring at us, and then pulled a 180 in the middle of the road, so.
Oh, really? So yeah, it's highly possible. We don't know.
I don't know for sure either.
Yeah.
But he was going really slow. Like, I went the speed limit, so he probably thought I was speeding off, but.
It's possible. So, yeah, pick up your stuff. Let me know when you're done.
Is there other stuff that you took too of mine?
No. I haven't taken any of your stuff yet because that's why I wanted you to pick up your stuff before I seize your items, the illegal ones. Are you missing something?
Yeah, you might have to check my truck quick, so maybe it's in there.
What is it you're looking for?
A wetsuit and rebreather. I'm pretty sure I put it in my truck, so.
Okay, yeah, no, there was definitely nothing like that when I checked.
Yeah, you mind if I just quickly look at my truck?
Yeah, well, go ahead and pick up all of the stuff that is legal. Are you good?
That's just the weapons there.
Okay, so go ahead and check your truck. Now, don't get in the truck, though, okay? Just you can check.
Don't worry about that.
Okay.
I just threw,
okay.
Yeah, it's never good.
Okay, awesome. Come back over here. Now, just so you know, right now, because obviously we have those illegal weapons, you're not under arrest, but I am going to detain both of you right now, just until I finalize my investigation, and obviously you guys got weapons, right? And it's only one of me, technically. He's just a ride-along. So, okay. For my safety, okay?
Yep.
All right, partner, do me a favor. Stand up real quick. Like I was telling your partner, right now you guys are going to be detained. You're not under arrest. You're just being detained until I finalize my investigation, okay? And so just bear with me, okay? I know it's taking a little bit of time, and I appreciate your cooperation.
Yes, thank you.
All right. All right, Hoffman, you can follow me now since they're secured right now. So if you want to follow me so you can hear the conversations. All right, my friends. So here's the deal. Now, I'm sorry. You're Mr. Adam, right?
No, Adam is.
Oh crap! I'm horrible Justin. With names. Apologize. All right, Justin. So Justin. So here's the deal. Talking to Adam. He's kind of your stories are not matching up, and it's concerning me a little bit. Now, because of all the hardware that you guys have, I hope you understand. It's leading me to believe that maybe, possibly, you guys might have broken into some of the houses, because I mean, there's just a lot of inventory on you. Okay, so before you say anything though that might incriminate yourself, again, you're not under arrest, but I do have to give you your rights. Okay, so you have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You do have a right for an attorney. If you cannot afford one, one can be appointed to you if available. Do you understand your rights?
Yep.
Okay. Now that you understand your rights, do you wish to continue to talk to me?
Sure.
Okay. So, I appreciate that. So, Justin, what's going on is that, like I said, Adam's kind of giving me a different story. I think he's kind of starting to lean. I'm sorry, just a second. Okay, so he's starting to lean more on possibly telling me that you guys did break into some homes. So what I want to do is I want to give you an opportunity to kind of come clean with me. Now, what I can do for you, if you guys come clean, now you have a lot of hardware, so there's a little bit of trouble there already. But if you guys come clean, then I'll try to reduce some of your charges so you guys you're not spending a lot of time, and then we just call it good and we move on with life. So what do you think, Mr. Justin? And now, let me say this before you say anything. I only give this opportunity one time. If you decide not to tell me what I think I already know, then it's the point of no return, and I'll just continue my investigation and file full charges. So I need to give you full disclosure before you say anything, okay? So do you understand that? So it's a one-time shot that you get, and that's it, okay? So go ahead and let me know what actually happened.
Leading up to the,
just tell me what I want to know. The stuff I already know, pretty much that happened. I just want to confirm it from you.
So me and Adam met up,
mm-hmm.
just outside, kind of campground area, because we were kind of meeting midway.
Okay.
Then we drove up north up the highway, and then came over from. I'm blanking now.
That's okay.
We were up north on the highway, and then we came over and we checked out those housing. Then he jumped in my truck, and I went up to Dartmouth, put some gas, and came back.
Okay. So at what point did the break-in into the homes happen?
That would have been prior.
Okay, so prior to that, you guys broke into – how many homes did we break into?
Prior to meeting up.
Okay.
Just myself, I did two.
You did too. Now, where you guys are about to do some together, because he has a lot of inventory on him too, and he's telling me – that he was partaking in some of it. So you're still not matching up to his story. So what's missing?
No idea. I don't know what he said. I don't know. So I can't really. Obviously, well, I don't. I'm not going to find out what he said. But
well, no, no. You just tell me what happened, and then there's nothing really to fabricate, right? You just tell me what actually happened.
That's what I did. I did go into two houses prior to meeting up with him.
Okay, so he wasn't with you when you broke into those homes.
No.
Hmm. Interesting. Why would he falsify something that's going to incriminate him when he wasn't there? That makes no sense. Hmm. Okay. Okay. Well, no. Are you sure that's it? Because before I close this chapter and I continue my investigation, are you sure that's the story you want to stick with?
Yeah.
Okay. So that's what it was. Okay. So now, unfortunately, you are under arrest. Okay. For the burglary that happened. Okay. Do you have any questions for me so far? Okay, perfect. And by the way, I still think you're a gentleman, and you've been very polite, and I appreciate that, even though I have to arrest you and do my job, okay? I hope you don't take it personal.
Yeah, no, it's all good.
All right, appreciate it, Justin. All right. So, Mr. Adam.
Yep.
How we doing, my friend?
Doing all right.
Okay. So, Mr. Adam, Justin came clean. He admitted to the burglaries that he was part of. So now he kind of told me the story on how you guys met and what transpired. So I'm going to give you the same opportunity that I gave him, which is possibly reducing some of the sentence, considering the hardware that you guys were carrying. But that's all dependent upon you telling me what I already know and confirming what I already know. Now, I only give this chance one time, okay? After you tell me what you're going to tell me, then pretty much the deal is closed. And then after that, I'll just do my investigation and file charges as I need to, okay? So, Mr. Adam, you seem to be a very cordial guy, very respectful to me thus far. So I'm going to ask you only one time, okay, for you to tell me the truth and tell me what actually happened and how you guys came across all the hardware that you guys were carrying, okay? So I'm going to go. You got the floor now. Go ahead. And again, a friendly reminder, I will only give you this chance one time, okay? Right. So make sure there's no lies in there. Go ahead.
All right. Well, when it comes to the hardware, he already had it by the time we met up. And when we were over there, we were looking for a house to break into.
Okay.
And we also did, when I was with him, we also did break into one set of the house. At least I did when I was with him. And as far as the hardware, he already had it by the time we met up.
Okay. So did you guys get any goods out of the house that you broke into together?
No.
No goods? It was in him. No, didn't have anything? Okay.
No.
Okay, well, let me say I do appreciate you giving me that information, okay? But so I do have to give you your rights. You got the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You do have the right for an attorney. If you cannot afford one, one will be appointed to you if available. Do you understand your rights?
Yes, I do.
Okay, very good. So, okay, now is there anything else I need to know as far as what happened?
No, sir.
All right. So how did you come across the Desert Eagle? Did he give it to you?
No. It wasn't him. It was another person that I met, and he said that he was selling one. And when he showed it to me, I figured that it would have been nice for my collection.
Okay, very good. All right, partner. Well, thank you again. Even though I have to do my job and arrest you, I still think you've been a gentleman and a scholar. I appreciate that. I appreciate your cooperation and being truthful with me. You are under arrest, though, now. Okay?
I understand.
Any questions for me thus far?
No, sir.
All right. Excellent. Mr. Frank. How you doing, buddy?
There he goes.
Hey, would you guys mind transporting one for me? I got one in my car already.
Yeah, we can do that.
Cool. I still need to search the vehicle, though, so let me do this first. Mr. Adam, where's the key? Is that in your front pocket, back pocket?
Yeah. It's in my front right.
Okay. Let me grab that. All right. Let's see here. Searching. Not getting close to the package, so don't worry. All right. There it is. All right. Found it. Got it. Thank you, sir. Give me just a sec.
Has he been patted down?
Yes. He's been... now, he has weapons on him, so he still needs to be... he has several weapons on him. Actually, both of them do. Originally, when this started... actually, I'll tell you about it here, Frank, in a minute. But, yes, he has weapons on him, so he needs to be...
Okay. Let's take him over there. And
yep.
We'll get him.
Thank you. All right. Let's check here. Oh, yeah. So here we go. So we got the typical tools used for this type of activity. So we got 9 lockpicks and 2 bolt cutters. So that verifies that they were up to no good, Mr. Hoffman. What's that?
Quite a jackpot, really.
Yeah. This one turned out good, for sure. So what I'm going to do, let me see here. Do me a favor. Well, let me see if it's going to let me take them. I'm going to take the tools that were used for the commission of the crime. Those that will not get back. And so pickaxe are good. Chicken, tactical, that's good. That I don't. I'll keep in there. Let's see if we can. We got a tow available. No, we don't. So we're going to have to use the county tow company. So let me make sure registration. Let me see here. So I see that. Okay, yeah. Let me run that tag. Tom Frank Boy 303. All right, yeah, it does come back to Mr. Annam. So that's good. So it is his vehicle. So we're going to go ahead and get that county to pick that up.
All right.
So that's good. We'll search our suspect over at the jail. So that's kind of cool. You'll get to experience that part. All right, Frank. I'm going to go ahead and head to the jail because I'm going to process my guy, and I'll meet you guys there with this other guy, okay? All right, the first thing I'm going to have you do is just watch your head as I pull you out. I don't want you to hit your head. And I might be pulling out. There we go. See? Like that. Pulled everybody out. I'm just that kind of guy. All right, Mr. Justin. Let's get you processed, amigo. We'll make it kind of quick for you, all right? All right, can you hear me, sir?
Yep.
All right, go ahead and sit still for a second. All right, now turn to your right. Sit still. All right, now turn to your left. Sit still. Excellent. All right, Mr. Adam, you can come back. Stand right here behind Justin. And Justin, you can go ahead and go up. Yeah, you're going to have to. All right, go ahead and go through the door and then stand in the middle of the room. Go ahead, Hoffman. I was saying go ahead.
Oh.
All right. All right, so let me see. What are we going to do here? Now, you know what? I'm going to give you a choice. Do you guys want to be in the same room together, or do you want to be in separate rooms?
Go together, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. All right, give me a second. Do not walk in yet, okay?
All right.
Okay, everything is good. All right, gentlemen, go ahead and step in. I need you both to face the back wall. And continue to face the back wall until I give you further directions. All right, Mr. Justin, come up to the door. Mr. Adam, stay where you're at, okay? All right, Mr. Justin, do you have plenty of food and water?
Yep.
Yeah. All right, you're good? All right, go ahead and go back to the wall, please. All right, Mr. Adam, come up to the door, please. Do you have plenty of food and water?
No, I need both.
That should carry you over.
All right. Thank you.
All right, gentlemen. You're free to run, move about, and let me know if you need anything. I'll be here, okay?
All right.
All right, gentlemen. Hello, gentlemen. How are we doing in there?
Doing good. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm good. I had a little diabetic attack. Hey, you guys ready for your large muscle exercise?
Yeah, I mean, he's sleeping, but I'm ready.
All right, let's go. All right, we're going to go this way. Follow me. Oh, my other one? He's still in the cell. He wanted to sleep.
Oh, okay.
He didn't want to exercise.
Yeah.
This guy, he's pumping it hard. That little dumbbell has him going.
Left arm.
Look. Hey, don't overwork at one arm, dude. Otherwise, you're going to be half buff, dude. Well, then the other side is going to be all jacked up.
That's true. So the right arm is used in other exercises.
Exactly. So that one gets exercise already. So work on the left. This guy cracks me up. Oh, he's one of those guys, those bodybuilders that, you know, they walk around and go, okay, here we go, all right, oh yeah, we're going to do this. And then they sit down and they go, never mind, I'll come back later.
Exactly. Watch this.
Are you ready? All right, do it. That still cracks me up, dude.
Oh, man.
Oh, God, dude. It's like the guy's going to get a hernia, man.
Lift up your legs.
Oh, dude, you got me rolling. I don't know why I find that so funny. Just the way you roll it back, bro. That's kind of cool.
No, if you scream, that helps. You gotta...